Last time we talked about products of sines and cosines and how to integrate them. We saw that you could do it using basic trig identities if you have an odd number of sines, and you can do it if you have an odd number of cosines. The hard case is when you have an even number of sines and an even number of cosines. This video is about what to do then. So the key is a double angle formula. Now, you know that we've got these formulas for the sine of twice an angle. It's 2 sine x cosine x, and for the cosine of twice an angle, that's cosine squared minus sine squared. Now, if you use the fact that cosine squared itself is 1 minus sine squared, you can rewrite that as 1 minus twice sine squared. And if you use the fact that sine squared is 1 minus cosine squared, you could also rewrite it as 2 cosine squared minus 1. Well, now let's look at this equation, cosine 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1. Add 1 to both sides, and divide by 2. Lo and behold, you get a formula for cosine squared in terms of cosine 2x. And likewise, you get a formula for sine squared. Sine squared is 1 minus cosine squared, and that's 1 half of 1 minus cosine of 2x. Pretty easy to see that these two things add up to 1. Okay, so the game is, if you've got an even number of powers of sine and an odd number of powers of cosine, think of these as sine squared to the n over 2 power, and rewrite everything in terms of cosine of 2x. Think of this as cosine squared to the m over 2 power, and rewrite everything in terms of cosine of 2x. And then you have a different trig integral involving powers of cosine of 2x, but you have fewer powers. And if you're lucky, you have an odd number of powers and you can handle it. If you're not so lucky, you have an even number of powers and you have to work a little bit harder. So here's an example. You want to find the integral of sine squared of x. Well, you just rewrite sine squared as 1 half of 1 minus cosine 2x. So this is integral of 1 half minus 1 half of cosine of 2x dx. And the integral of 1 half is just x over 2. And the integral of cosine of 2x is sine of 2x divided by 2. We've got a half of that, so it's divided by 4. And we're done. Now, if you want, you can take this and convert it back into functions sine of x and cosine of x. So this does turn out to be x over 2 minus 1 half sine of x cosine of x plus c. But this last step is optional. This is a correct answer. There are times that you want to convert it back to just sine and cosine. There are times that you don't have to. Now, it doesn't always work in one step. If you were interested in the integral of sine squared times cosine squared, you would convert the sine squared to 1 half of 1 minus cosine 2x, the cosine squared into 1 half of 1 plus cosine 2x, and that becomes 1 quarter of 1 minus cosine squared of 2x dx. And then you say, uh-oh, I'm stuck. I've got two powers. I still have two powers. I don't know how to deal with two powers. Except you do. You use the same trick again. See, this is 1 quarter of the integral of sine squared of 2x. So that's 1 eighth of 1 minus cosine of 4x. dx. And that you know how to integrate. That's 1 eighth of x minus sine of 4x divided by 4 plus a constant, and you're done. Sometimes you have to do the trick 3 times or 4 times or 5 times. You do it as many times as you have to. And it'll always stop because when you do the trick, you cut the number of powers in half. You keep cutting the powers in half, you will eventually run out of powers.